Hello, everybody. Welcome to the last countdown of the week. What a week it has been. The games have been epic. Cannot wait for 15 more rounds today. Also, Rachel loved having Annie McManus in Dictionary Corner, and her new book that is out this week, yep. The Mess We're In. I don't want to give anything away, but it charts that kind of journey of a young girl moving from Ireland to London, to the big city, if you like. So many of us watching can sort of relate to that, whether it was for uni or for work. And you and I, well, you were brought up in the seaside, as we know. What was it like for you when you moved to the capital?
Well, you don't realise the whole north, south, east, west thing till you live there. I remember people be like, I'm from London. You're like, and if they're from London, they're like, what part of London? So it's just London, isn't it? And then you just realise that it's so many small villages and towns all shoved together.
But big cities can really eat you up. They're glorious in one way, but they're very cold and unforgiving in another. You know, you've got to have a certain energy to negotiate your way through them. Or they can eat you up.
Yeah, but I think you just find your small little part, so it's just broken down. So the first bit I lived in London was kind of Ladbroke Grove, Holland Park area. So you can just walk down to Notting Hill, you've got Hyde Park and Kensington Gardens, and it's just lovely. And you don't tend to move out of your little area because everything's there that you know.
Absolutely. Well, listen, this is a great account of it, The Mess We're In. Annie's book is exactly about that journey to the big city. Good luck with it, Annie. Great to have you in Dictionary Corner alongside our Susie Dent. One more day together. Yes. I've decided to put together an orchestra. Ronan, our two-time champion, 242 points in two appearances. The wonder kid. We love Ronan. You're my violin player. Tell me all about it.
I have done violin. I have been a violin player in my younger years. Yeah, quite enjoyed it.
I love that. In his younger years, he's 17. I love that. Yeah. Are you qualified?
Wouldn't really say so.
Well, Ronan, you're up against a man of distinction today. Greg Rain lives in Sheffield. He is interested in Italian Renaissance art, classical music, plays chess, plays the cello. So are you more qualified at cello than Ronan is at the violin?
Probably not, but I enjoy playing it. Done so since a young age and still carry on if I can. Yeah. So, yeah, just enjoy playing it, really. And yeah.
Good luck to Greg today. Good luck to Ronan. Let's see who can hit the right note. Ronan, I believe the phrase is your first chair. Off we go.
Hi, Rachel.
Hi, Ronan.
I'll start with a vowel, please.
Thank you. Start today with O.
And another?
E.
And another?
I.
And another?
A.
Consonant?
N.
And another?
T.
And another?
R.
And another?
S.
And a consonant, please.
Lastly, C.
At home and in the studio, let's play countdown. Ronan.
Nine.
Greg.
Oh, just a five.
The five is?
Stain.
Right, Ronan, a max.
Creations.
Creations.
Well done.
What a start for Ronan. 18 points on the board. But, Susie, you've got a smile on your face.
There were a few nines hiding there, actually. We had a couple more, didn't we?
We did. We had actioners, we had reactions, and we had narcotize.
Can I just comment on the aesthetics of Dictionary Corner today? I might need to bring Rachel in on this.
It's like we planned it.
It is.
It is sensational. It's a bit Tarantino-esque.
I think it's because they look like penguins. I think that's why you like it.
That's exactly it. Right. Let's waddle on then. Greg, let's get your letters.
Hi, Rachel.
Hi, Greg.
Can I have a vowel, please?
You can indeed. E.
Can I have a consonant, please?
R.
Can I have another consonant, please?
G.
And another, please.
W.
Can I have a vowel, please?
O.
And another one, please.
E.
And a consonant, please.
P.
And another one, please.
M.
And a vowel, please.
A final A.
30 seconds for everyone. How many?
Oh, just a five again.
The five there. No worries, my friend. Ronan?
Try an eight.
You're going to try the eight. Greg, the five?
Wager.
Join the club. And Ronan?
Tapeworm.
Tapeworm, I've heard of. But gapeworm, Susie?
Yes. Oh, you know your dictionary, Ronan. This what? Tells me this. Yes, I've never heard of a gapeworm. The dictionary certainly has. A parasitic nematode worm that infests the bronchi of birds and causes them to gape.
An amazing start. We wouldn't add gapeworm. Anything at all?
Didn't even have an eight. We had Empower at seven.
Empower it.
Yeah.
Yeah. Sensational stuff from Ronan. Let's switch to the numbers for the first time today. Off you go, champ.
Can I have one from the top, please, Rachel?
You can indeed. One large, five little. Coming up, first numbers of the day. One, eight, ten, six, four, and 25. And the target to reach 468.
468, numbers up. How'd you get on, Ronan?
468.
Bang on the button, Greg.
467.
One away, Ronan, for 10 points.
10 plus 8 is 18.
10 plus 8, 18.
25 plus 1 is 26. And times them together.
Very neat when you spot it. Yep, yeah. 468, lovely.
Yeah, very good. Only if you spot it. Let's get our first tea time teaser of the day. Love this one. Violet rat. Violet rat. Does he put tacks on a jacket spod? High up lifting. Does he put tacks on a jacket spod? High up lifting.